बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। माय नेम इज़ उमर लियाकत, स्टडिंग एमफिल इन जूलॉजी फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ जूलॉजी वाइल्ड लाइफ एंड फिशरीज इन यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर फैसलाबाद। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू प्रेजेंट पॉपुलेशन डायनामिक्स ऑफ पेस्ट एंड देयर नेचुरल एनिमीज इन शुगर केन क्रॉप। हियर इज सम कंटेंट, इंक्लूड इंट्रोडक्शन, मेथडोलॉजी, रिजल्ट, conclusions, references. Introduction. We know that sugarcane is the major and cash crop of Pakistan. It provides many sugarcane products. Pakistan is at the 5th position in the world for the production of sugarcane and at the 8th position for the consumption of sugarcane and sugarcane products. Sugarcane production in Pakistan is lower as compared to the last years, as the report of GAIN. Due to increasing demand of sugarcane in Pakistan, there is need to examine the factors and the phenomena which cause yield loss. Many factors affecting the sugarcane yield loss, but in these factors, pests are the most important. 265 species of pests affecting the sugarcane, and which are related to the 64 families and 7 order. These pests are self-feeders, leaf-eating, phytophytes and stem borers. The agro ecosystem are dynamics in nature, we know that, and it has many important in the ecosystem. So keeping the importance of pest dynamics phenomena in nature and their relationship with the natural enemies, a study was conducted to find out the population dynamics of pests and their natural enemies in sugarcane crop. With the objective include population trend of biological agent to check the population fluctuation of pest in sugarcane ecosystem and approach to check how much biological control are present. My methodology and methodology, I done my study in entomological field, Jangwala Entomology Department of Entomology, University of Agriculture, Faisalabad, where all the agronomic practices are done. Here is my field picture where I done my study, and I use RCBD layout for making blocks and sub-blocks and divides area into blocks and sub-blocks. The random sampling method was used for the observation of population. Each sampling size was considered as the replica and the area was divided into 5 blocks. The distance between each block will be 2 cm. Here is the map of my study area and the field, which showed at 5 different 5 division of RCBD layout. Let's start with the result. Population dynamics of pest. I start with the population dynamics of pest first and then with the natural enemies. The population of Prela shows start showing during the end of the April and reach to the peak toward the mid of the October. Similarly, the borers, 3 types of borer mainly study: root borers, toe borers, and stem borers. And these borers show population trend only during the end of the July toward the start of end of the August. These borers are not much present in the SPF variety 247. Population dynamics of Acrididae and the grasshopper and the shorthorn hopper are mainly studied. Grasshopper show greater fluctuation than that of the shorthorn hopper. Population dynamics of beet webworm, it showed that high growth, high peak population fluctuation during the mid of the August to the third week of September, and then decline toward the October, mid of the October. Now discuss about the population dynamics of natural enemies. First, I am going to discuss about ladybird beetle. 127 specimens were recorded, and during the study, population minimum during the start of the July and growth at the mid of the October, and then to, toward the end of the study period. Green jasmine show little fluctuation, and it from the August to the October. Population dynamics of apiparoid, which are the pest of the natural enemy of the parela, and it show growth during the mid of the August to September. And similarly, parasitoid species, I study barconid webs, which show the population growth and show the peak value at the end of the at the mid of the September. Conclusions of my study include the parela population. This graph showed that the parela population is higher than their natural enemies, and this graph also showed that the acridiidae and the grasshopper shorthorn population less than that of the parasitic wasps and spider, but the wasps and spider population less than that of the parela population. Here is the beet web worm, show higher growth than the natural enemies. So there is no synchrony between the natural enemies and pest to control the pest in a sugarcane field. Mainly the pest population is lower. The results show that greater dynamics present in pest population of pest and their natural enemies sugarcane crop during the trial period from 3rd week to July. Overall, the population of pest higher than the natural enemies. The study showed that the population of both pest and natural enemies are on the top during the August, and the natural enemy population declined toward the end of the October. Overall, two major peaks of pest were recorded. First, during the start of experiment, during 3rd week of the July, and during the end of the 3rd week of the August and the 2nd of October. This study helped the farmer in many ways. If we know the population dynamics of pest, we can easily manage the pest. It tell about the emergence of pest and natural and of pest and natural enemy and the time of its peak, and it also helped to in time management and spraying of insecticide and pesticide if natural control is not present. Here is references of some my study. And thank you for your attention.